Hello and welcome back to the essay Education of a British Protected Child written by Chinua Achebe. This is the sixth video on this essay. As we have seen in the last video, Achebe was a Christian child growing up in a partly Christianized land. And he gives the analogy of Moses. It was already given in page number 115, and he says that he had been looked after by his culture like Moses was looked after by his own mother. And the role of River Nile in Moses' story was there for River Niger in his own story. As a child from a Christian family, he was excluded from the sights and sounds of the village or the culture, Igbo culture, but this exclusion actually made them all the more attractive for him. Like all other children, he looked forward to the Nuafa festival, which was actually celebrated. It was a major holiday in the traditional year. It was celebrated for the ancestors. Ancestral spirits masqueraded in the village. They walked around the village. Coming out of their ant holes, they came to visit the living. That was the belief. There were hundreds of these masquerades walking around for 8 days. And children like Achebe, they used to count the number of masquerades that they saw during this period. You can see the picture of the masquerades on the screen. They usually carried a whip with them. They used to punish them with this whip, and sometimes they punished the people around, and it was to show their toughness. Even if these children saw a same masquerade 10 times, they will count it as one. And counting thus, they got at least 100 in each season. Thus, the Christians and the non-Christians shared the sights, sounds and the speeches of the village. Church had divided people into two. Christianity had divided people into the people of the church, the people of the world. Even though they spoke the same language, the matter was different. Like the Christian people spoke about something else while the non-Christians spoke about something else, but the language was same. The church had once tried to unify the language. They used to unifying it into an official language, but people or the priests did not use that. They knew that they could not connect to the common man using the unified language. And people used to be restricted from interacting with their heathen neighbors by the church, but the crossings were there. The cultural crossings were there, and Achebe says that traffic was heavy on the crossings. So cultural exchange was there. The Christians admired and somehow got connected to the Igbo culture. The Igbos, the non-Christians, they were amused by the services in the church, and they even mimicked the songs in the church. Other than the traditional Igbo festivals, there were two important Christian festivals. It was Easter and Christmas. Even though the priest told them Easter was more important than Christmas, all Igbo Christians, they believed that Christmas was most important. There were two secular festivals in the Igbo land. One was the Empire Day, which was Queen Victoria's birthday. It was on May 24th. Another is Anniversary. It commemorated the coming of Gospel into the Igbo land. It was celebrated on July 27th. Empire Day was a major school event, and school children from all over the district would march in contingents or uniforms past the British resident who stood on a dais wearing a white ceremonial uniform with white gloves, plumed helmet and sword. It was usual to have a kind of sports competition among the school children. Chibi remembers an incident in which his school, with a lot of big boys, gave in a competition of tug of war. It was rumored later that the headmaster had asked the children, the students, to give in because they had the opponent as an Anglican school. In order to make another Catholic school lose the competition, they had an agreement. These two Anglican schools had an agreement, and Achebe's school lost deliberately. An important memory that Achebe had about Empire Day was when he was 10 years old. He was in third standard in 1940, perhaps. He remembers it as 1940. He had visited Onitsha, where the celebrations, Empire Day celebrations, took place, being the provincial headquarters. So he went there all alone, without anyone accompanying him. So that was a unique experience for him. He saw the magical place Onitsha, and he had heard of it for a long time. It lived up to the reputation. And he also describes the sight of River Niger glimmering, and his breath was taken away by the sight of the beautiful river. He had learned about the river in his school. The river had traveled actually from the origin, where it originated, in Phutjalan Mountains. It had traveled 2,600 miles to reach Onitsha. And Achebe was from a family which believed passionately in education, and he had school books that his older brothers and sisters studied. So his background was something that supported his education, and he was an enthusiastic student. He was nicknamed Dictionary by his friends. He was not so good at games, but that was not a problem in their culture. Their culture did not seriously hold that against anybody. Two things that he remembered about that visit. One is, since he was all alone, he had no one to control him. He had some money, and he ate half a penny worth groundnuts on that day. And since then, the memory of even the mention of groundnuts would turn his stomach. He was so full with groundnuts. Second memory is a more happy memory. That is the memory of seeing a person called Dr. J.M. Stuart Young. This was a legendary person, because when he was living in Ogidi, people had told him a lot about Onitsha. So he was seeing that legendary place now. Now, this person was also a legend. He had heard a lot about him, and he was walking down the New Market Road bareheaded in the sun. People had told him, Achebe, that you will see that person walking around without a hat. That was there in the legend. Another aspect of that legend was that Stuart Young had a pact with a mermaid who asked him to stay single in return for the riches that he got. Later on, Achebe learned something more about this person. One knowledge that he had was the details of his doctoral degree was actually doubtful. And again, the story about how he had come to Nigeria as a colonial civil servant, and he turned against the colonial system and became a merchant. And what did he do? He challenged With African support, he challenged the monopoly of European commercial cartels. Actually, he turned against his own people and stayed in Africa. He also wrote and published poetry and fiction. Achebe says that later in one work, I invoked his memory. That work is Uncle Ben's Choice. So these are the pictures of Queen Victoria, J.M. Stuart Young. This is the picture of Mount Fujialan, from where River Niger originates. So these are all about Achebe's visit to Onitsha. And the other secular festival, as we have seen, it is the anniversary, which is the coming of the gospel to the Igbo land. It was in memory of how Bishop Ajay Crowther and his missionary team came to Onitsha in 1857. It was on July 27th. They were beaten by heavy rain, it was said. And the happy thing about this festival was that school children were fed yam during this festival. And for most people, this was their first taste of juicy new yam for the year, because yam production started around that period and they had the taste of yam. So feeding yam was only an important part of this anniversary. So that's all for this time. We will continue in our next video. I have chosen certain words and given the meanings as a glossary in this video. Please go through them and read the textbook along with them. They will help you to understand the essay better. These words are from both video number 5 and video number 6. That's all for this time. We will continue in the next video. Thank you.